Okay, Jim Feig, coming back to you from South Bridge Street Live with my word of wisdom for today. And this morning, I want to talk about this beautiful building that you see on the wall here. This is the home of the Victoria Art League. It's located on South Bridge Street. That might sound familiar to you. Yes, this is where the programming for South Bridge Street Live started originally. That's where our live program was first done. This building's an interesting building. It's had several previous lives. It was built right about 1894 or 5 or 6 or 7. It makes it about 120 years old. Originally a mercantile, a store where you could buy just about anything from potatoes to chickens to hardware cloth to nails and staples and tools and whatever you wanted, it was for sale in there, a mercantile store. They'd handle all kinds of produce and dry good, and then sometime later, it was converted into what we call a farmer cooperative, a farmer's co-op. The farmer's co-op was dealing with processing and selling such things as grain and feed for livestock. So it was an active building in several different places. In fact, there's even rumors that it once served as a brothel. And if you look at the way the little rooms are made up in the top of that building, you probably believe it because it looks that way. This was originally the part of the old downtown Victoria, Texas. In the early 1900s, there was a bridge. This Bridge Street actually had a bridge across the river. Railroad wasn't there yet. But all the ox-drawn wagons and the stagecoaches and the horse riders from Goliad and San Antonio and Corpus Christi and points south and west of Victoria would come into town across that river bridge, right up Bridge Street, right past this building. This is one of the first buildings they saw when they got into Victoria. Very nice building. It was when it was new. But like everything else, it deteriorates with time. So by the mid-1970s, that's quite a while ago now, the mid-1970s, this building was scheduled to be torn down. It was dilapidated. The flooring was gone. You had to be careful walking around inside of it. It was just in terrible shape. And they were going to tear it down until a gentleman named Harold Nichols came along. Now Harold was a visionary. He looked at something and he saw something of value in it. And he did that with this old building. He bought it and started it, converting it into, well, first of all, he made it his home. And then he started repairing it and patching it up and converting it into an art community and an event rental facility. And Harold put this building back together to the point where it was making him an income in the event rentals and providing him with pleasure as his art community. He had a lot of artist friends that would come and gather, and they would meet there and have a good time. So the Victoria Art League purchased this building from Harold back in 1989, I think it was. No, 1998. I'm sorry, 1998. Back in 1998, and the Art League has been doing a wonderful job of restoring it more all the time. This is a beautiful building. We need to preserve buildings like this, not tear them down. There are other buildings around that have been preserved like this as well. Offhand, if you go over to Goliad, you've got the Missions and the Presidio over there, beautiful restorations. I enjoy going over there and taking photographs quite often. The painted church is over around the Schulenburg area, another beautiful example, and again, a very good example to go and photograph. But far too many of these beautiful examples from the past are not valued like they should be. People are quick to try to tear them down to put something else in their place. To some, I guess these beautiful structures are just in the way of progress, and that's unfortunate. And the quicker they can push them out of the way to make room for something modern, the faster they feel they will be moving forward. Well, personally, I think we need to value the efforts of those that came before us and learned from us and treasure the things that they left for us, like these old buildings. Actually, there are even some modern treasures that have succumbed to the wrecking ball and the bulldozer. I'll give you a classic example. In 2015, the year 2015, a group of artists came to Victoria for an event, and they left us with some beautifully painted walls scattered about town. Oh, some people call it graffiti, but I looked upon it as art. Beautiful art. Beautiful art. One shining example of this was what I called the graffiti wall on Constitution Street. It was painted on walls that belonged to a bank, a drive-in bank that was no longer in use. It was an artistic treasure that many photographers used as a background to take portraits and other types of photographs against. Others would just come to admire it like a museum. But it's no longer there. The bulldozers got it. I talked to the person that was tearing it down, and they were proud of what they were doing. I was sad. The bulldozers got it. And we need to pay more attention to things like this, to our heritage. Things that have been given to us by those who preceded us. They worked hard to make a beautiful world, and we need to work hard to keep it that way. So speak out when you see some treasure that needs protection. Give it the protection it needs. Let me tell you more about the graffiti wall. I've got a poem here. I'm going to change the photo now, and this is a picture of the graffiti wall as they were tearing it down. And it was sad. It says, "The graffiti wall is coming down this week." Oh, I read about it in the Advocate. It said the street art would be gone forever, leaving naught but bricks and wire and posts. Oh, a sad day for the art community. Soon it'll be a parking lot, probably, or a fancy shack for a fast food chain. I guess it's more valuable that way to those who don't really appreciate the art. And here's another photo of the graffiti wall as I continue. This is another example of how they were tearing it down. Oh, this wasn't just some random color blobs scattered on the wall of brick and steel. Oh, this had character. It had life. It brightened up the day of all who stopped to see, but now it's gone forevermore. No more a background for a portrait shot. And no more a pattern for the cover page or a brightly colored abstract print. A tragic loss indeed to all the world of art. Jim Feig, your master photographer coming from Southbridge Street Live. I'll see you again. Thank you.